Before starting chanting, you can sit for a moment. Remember the view that all beings, ourselves included, have Buddha nature that is clear, pure, perfect. Remember the view that we have this basic goodness in us. Basic goodness, something that is profound and complete in itself. So if and when we live in the confused, self-based mind state, thinking in terms of self and other in dualistic fashion, when we shift from that kind of mind, samsaric mind, to our basic mind or wakeful mind, wakeful nature, you know, we feel very fresh. Very fresh, clear, mind becomes clear. You know, that same mind that is usually clouded by thoughts, emotions like anger and anxiety and fear, all those disperse. And clarity and freshness, this pure mind, pure awareness, comes experienced. So when that nature of mind shows up, just let recognition of that happen. It happens by itself, without me or I doing the recognition. And that's exactly the release, the benefit, that we know ourselves without a contracted self-entity or without Atma, like it is said in Buddhist theory. So when we recognize this basic nature, if we can recognize it, somebody who's very stressed and very confused about life and existence in general, it can be impossible to have this recognition. Technically speaking, if one hasn't had awakening experiences or bumi openings, then might be very difficult to have this recognition. Simply because there's so much stuff piled on this basic nature. So that's why we have all kind of techniques, practices, such as mantras. And next we're going to chant the three basic syllables of the Buddha within, related to, technically speaking, related to the so-called Mahasiddha Bhumis, 11th, 12th, and 13th grounds in our energy body. A, ba, hu, root syllables. So when you chant with a relaxed feeling, with a sense of openness and expansion. You know, when you chant, let your voice reverberate in the room you're sitting in. And let those mantras, those sounds open up, kind of massage your body, your whole being. Let it massage your heart so that you really relax from the deep. During the chanting, you can also see if you can feel the energy in these mantric syllables and see how you begin to feel much clearer and fresher and better because the basic goodness shows up. This kind of introduction I would perhaps give for beginners who are joining this kind of chanting session. All right, then we start.
Thank you.
Thank you. Resting in recognition that comes through the blessing in those syllables. Recognizing basicness in us in a silent fashion. surrendering completely to this felt energy, letting those blessings, that energy charge, go through the whole body, through one's whole being. In other words, surrendering. Letting the energy flow freely through the legs, letting it flow freely through the arms, through the torso, and through the head. So we simply either stay with this recognition through the charge, through the energy, meaning with the help of the internal energy aspect, recognizing the secret nature of mind, and also if you understand and practice vipassana, emptiness meditation, if something arises, some notions, observations, impressions, perceptions, looking directly into those observations and impressions to see whether there is a me, I, self there. And when the self is found, staying with it, looking at it, feeling into it, so that it can be released. And recognition of the nature of mind can be furthered. Also, different emotions come up momentarily, anger, frustration. Some memory may trigger irritation, or irritation might come up by itself somehow. Whatever arises, looking into it, seeing through it. For the sake of all sentient beings, as always. stay with it, we'll continue in lying down posture for about 10 minutes.